very warm welcome to this, the final concert of Haddo Arts Festival 2021. It's been a wonderful week of concerts, mixing live events with pre-recorded performances, and we hope you've enjoyed this very special 10th anniversary programme. Also, a huge thank you to the National Trust for Scotland, who continue to partner the festival and allow so much to take place in and around Haddo House. We end on a real high, that's spelled R-E-E-L, because we are delighted that one of Scotland's finest collection of musicians, the Whistlebinkies, round things off for us today. The Whistlebinkies have thrilled audiences at music societies, festivals and folk clubs for decades, and the fabulous music and playing has taken them from Beijing to Bachen. Well, they embrace a range of music and styles, but together they focus on Scottish traditional music. And today they'll play selections of traditional marches, strathspeys and jigs, as well as contemporary pieces very much in the traditional style. Now, some of the music you'll hear reflects where we are in the country, with lots of Aberdeenshire connections like Huntley and the eponymous hero-villain of Shakespeare's Scottish play. And no, I'm not saying the name. So without any further ado, sit back with the audience at Haddo House Hall and enjoy The Whistlebinkies. Thank you.
thank you very much for that round of applause. And as Roger said, the Whistlebinkies are here again, and we are very happy to be back playing after a fallow 18 months, but we're sprouting again, and here we are in Aberdeenshire again. We've been pleased to play in Aberdeenshire at the Folk Club for its 21st anniversary, at Paul Anderson's New Year's show, and in Tornaveen Village Hall. So we're familiar with the county, and Ian on double bass has just bought 25 kilos of the oats of Alford, the organic oats of Alford. So we'll be sharing that out and eating it every day for breakfast. So that'll keep us fit. We're going on now to play a tune that may have been heard in the early 16th century at the Battle of Flodden, and it commemorates one of the early Jacobite characters, Sir John Fenwick. And it's called, in tribute to him, it's called Sir John Fenwick, the Fleur Among Them All.
Thank you. O Luli, Luli, cam she in, and Luli she lay doon. I kent her by her collar lips, and her breasts sae sma' and roon. A' through the nicht we spak nayward, nor sindert bane frae bane. A' through the nicht I heard her hurt, gang soonden wi' my ain. It was about the wakref oor, when cocks begin to craw, that she smooled softly through the murk afore the day would daw. Say Luli, Luli cam she in, say Luli, was she gain? And wi' her aw my summer days, like they had never been.
Thank you. thought I should maybe tell you about this, a little bit about this fiddle. This instrument belonged to my great-grandfather, who was called Frank Savage, and he bought it in Glasgow in 1888. It was made by a Glasgow violin maker called James Gilchrist. And the fiddle actually has been a wreck for my whole life. It was passed down to my grandfather and ended up in my dad's loft in about a million different pieces. And my dad was 80 years old just a couple of months ago. And kind of for sentimental reasons as much as anything, I thought it'd be nice to have the fiddle restored. So it was restored by a brilliant fiddle maker called Philip Solomon down in Dumfries and Galloway. And I played on it in Aberdeen a couple of weeks ago. And I reckon you're probably only the second live audience ever to hear this violin, because I'm not sure historically if my great-grandfather would have played it much in public, or my own grandfather certainly didn't, to my knowledge. So this is 1888. It was bought in Glasgow. So I thought I'd just tell you a little bit about it. And it's also kind of relevant to the piece we're going to play just now. Because I'm from Ayrshire, I've always been very kind of fascinated with the whole thing of the Scots leaving, first of all, to go to Ireland and then over to America. And I reckon that in my own family, there has been at least one or two people who have left these shores and gone to America at the start of the 20th century. So it's a subject, partly from where I'm from, that's always really fascinated me. And I've been to America a few times, but I wrote this tune in 2013. I was heading over to America, and I was just kind of thinking about that whole thing of people leaving these shores and never coming home again. I was coming back again in 3 weeks' time, but I was kind of inspired to write this with the thoughts of people in past centuries who have left and never to return. So it's called Leaving for America, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
many theatres throughout the world, it is not permitted to say the title of the next piece. But away with all superstition, because in this area, Macbeth is held in high esteem, because this is his kingdom. And the fact is, his queen was called Good Queen Gruach as well. And I believe a local fiddler, Paul Anderson, has written a play, a musical play, about the good side of Macbeth. So I think we're permitted to say his name without worry in this theatre. So, but the next piece takes us back to the 1980s when the group was asked to play the music for an all-Scottish language production of Macbeth. The producer was Tom Kinnamont, who's still alive in his late 80s, living in London now. But Tom had the idea of putting binaural sound into this, so when I wrote the music, I was commissioned to write the music for it. And the opening scene has Rab wandering through the mists with the pipes around the battlements of the castle. And in the binaural sound, you listen to the radio with earphones and you could hear Rab ascending the steps and walking around your head and back down your neck again. And it was really eerie to hear that. But coupled with it were a couple of other players called Don Durrant and the late Jimmy Durrant, who played viola and percussion, and they added a lot of the eerie, ghastly sound effects that go with that play. So you might hear a few echoes of that tonight. I'm not sure where they're going to come from, but you'll hear them. So this is the music for Macbeth. It opens with the pipes around the castle, and then we hear a kind of lonely sound of concertina, fiddle and flute. But then it's taken over by the pipes again, and gradually a march to the battle evolves, a 6-8 march. But then we hear the lonely sounds of Lady Macbeth, Good Queen Gruach, in other words, sitting there playing her clarsach. And gradually she's overcome by ghastliness. And that's when Peter comes in and drowns her out. And we lead into the final conflict, and good triumphs over evil in the end. So that's Macbeth, the music for Macbeth.
Thank you.
Skinner tunes, so here we go.
Thank you.
superb programme from the Whistlebinkies. A huge thank you to Peter Anderson, who was on side drum in Buran. We had Ian Crawford on double bass. Stuart Edelman played concertina and fiddle. And also on fiddle, we had Mark Hayward and Alistair Savage. On flute and piccolo was Eddie Maguire. And Rona Mackay played Karsach with Rob Wallace and Roland Pipes and Small Pipes. So a thank you to all of them and to the audience at Haddo House and, of course, to you watching online. We hope you enjoyed the concert and all the other programmes from this year's festival. Also, if you would like to donate to the festival, you can by clicking the button and following the link. As we say in Scotland, every mickle makes a muckle, and your mickle might just make the difference to the work that Haddo Arts does here in the northeast of Scotland. So from me, Jamie McDougall, and everyone at the festival, it's goodbye from this year's 10th anniversary celebrations. Goodbye.